Hello friends, welcome to Technic. This is Nirmal here, and in this video we're going to talk about the Gcam on the OnePlus Nord. So OnePlus Nord has a quad camera setup. We have a primary 48 megapixel sensor, 8 megapixel ultra wide angle camera, a 2 megapixel depth sensor, 2 megapixel macro sensor, and a 5 megapixel depth sensor, and we have a dual selfie camera. It's a 32 plus 8 megapixel camera. So we have done a detailed camera review of this device, found this camera to be quite good. Now many of you have been asking us to try out Gcam on the OnePlus Nord to see if that brings up any improvements or changes to the overall camera processing. So Gcams are known for better overall processing. Let's see if the current build we have right now with us does produce any better images than the stock app on the OnePlus Nord. So we have this app installed. So this is the Gcam we have on this device. So I'll share the link in the description of this video. In case you have the Nord, you can just try out this. So we have all the basic features. You can see HDR Plus is available, then portrait mode, night sight, and other options including panorama, slow motion, time lapse, all works. 4K at 60 fps is available on this with the Gcam, while the stock camera app can't go up to 4K 60 fps, only 4K 30 fps is supported. But one thing what was missing on the Gcam right now is that there is no electronic image stabilization on offer, so videos are not stable. So probably in the coming build it might be fixed. So other than that, it looks quite okay. Now we have portrait mode as well as video recording mode, which again supports 4K at 60 fps. So now let's go straight into the camera sample comparison between the Gcam as well as the stock cam. First, let's have a look at the 4K 60 fps video taken with the OnePlus Nord. So this is the 4K 60 fps video shot with the Gcam, which provides 4K 60 fps. The default camera app does not have that. It looks quite good. As I said before, there is no stabilization. But this is not really useful if you're taking videos while walking or moving. It does not have stabilization. Now next, let's have a look at the daylight captures taken with these two camera apps. So you could see that both offer quite similar performance, not a drastic difference between the Gcam as well as the stock cam. But one thing what we noticed is that there is a small difference in terms of saturation levels on the Gcam. So Gcam has slightly lesser saturation levels and while compared to the stock camera. Now the sharpness levels are also a tad better and lesser noise in daylight captures. But again, these are not by a huge margin, very less difference. So if you look at side by side, you won't actually see unless you zoom in and see. So that's the performance of the Gcam with the stock camera. Now moving on to the close-up shots, this is one area where we could clearly see the saturation differences. So Gcam produces much better shots with the colors when compared to the stock camera, which actually saturates for the reds and the greens. So that way the Gcam does a better job in terms of the close-up shots. Now moving on to the portraits, you can see the Gcam produces slightly natural shots. Now again, the exposure was not very perfect on the Gcam, but still it is slightly better in terms of overall portrait experience when compared to the stock camera. Now HD detection was quite similar on both the apps. Now moving on to the low light experience. Here we could see that in indoor lighting conditions, no major difference again. And even in outdoor low light conditions, we didn't see any drastic difference between these two devices. Both did a quite good job. Now night mode, we didn't see any drastic difference between the stock camera as well as the Google camera. In fact, Google camera has produced better shots in nightscape, but here we couldn't see much of difference. In fact, the stock camera app did perform better than the Gcam in terms of the nightscape or the night mode. Now finally, the selfie experience, here again we couldn't see much of a difference. The stock camera whitening effect was slightly lower on the Gcam, so that way Gcam did a slightly better job in terms of the overall skin tones. Again, in terms of the edge detection in portrait shots also, the Gcam did a slightly better job. So that was the selfie experience. So this definitely helps in better selfie. So now finally, the selfie video, we'll have a look at the selfie video as well. So this is the front facing camera sample taken with the OnePlus Nord using the default camera app. So you can judge yourself how good the clarity of the video is and also the audio output from the front camera. So this is the video recording taken using the front facing camera using the Gcam APK on the OnePlus Nord. So you can judge yourself how good the clarity of the video is and also the audio output from the video. So having a look at the camera samples taken with the Gcam as well as the stock camera app, we can't say that Gcam brings in drastic difference to the overall camera performance. Yes, the saturation levels are tad lesser, but then you don't get the macro camera or the ultra wide angle camera, nor the ultra wide angle camera for the selfie dual camera setup. So those things are missing on the Gcam. So if you want the slightly better images, do go with Gcam for the daylight shots. But then probably you can use both simultaneously, like for ultra wide angle you can go with the regular camera app, while for portraits or for selfies you can go with the Gcam. So you can use both the cams to get the best pictures from OnePlus Nord. So that is the Gcam versus stock camera app comparison of the OnePlus Nord. So hope you enjoyed watching this video. Do hit that like button and also hit the red subscribe button for more videos. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.